Robyn's a very complex person. She's a musician, a singer, and also a art director, festival director, writer. Very widely accomplished over a whole range of fields. And that became increasingly interesting for me to try to express in some way that complexity. The challenges were to try to make sense of a very complex character. Robyn herself described her own sense of being as only existing at the intersection of lines of tension. And that stuck with me. And what I tried to do in the painting was paint about lines, about flow, about facets, which happened to make up Robyn. So that was the challenge of how to bring that complexity into a single image. I do feel compelled to do creative things, to paint or to design. I'm not one of those painters who has to paint every day, but the longer I leave it, not doing it, then there'll be this building urge to get back and either paint or draw or do something. So I can't describe it. It comes from somewhere. I think the Black Swan's important to the art world in Australia in many ways. I think the key way, though, is that it introduces a much broader audience to the arts. And I think arts is often guilty. The arts is often guilty of setting up barriers to what could be a potentially great audience. The Black Swan is one of those doors that allows people to access art and come into the tent. The other great thing about the Black Swan, I think, is that it's all about telling Australian stories. And I think one of the wonderful things is that each of the images has its own story. It's a story about how the image was made, the process, but also who the people were and what contribution do they make to individual lives or to all of our lives. One of the defining characters is that it brings an even broader audience to the field of art, and it does that particularly through things such as the Youth Awards in it. I think it's a wonderful thing to see that kids will be coming to the Black Swan, and it'll be maybe their first engagement with the idea of a gallery and the idea of visual art, and you just hope that it stimulates some passion within a few of them. And for those that it doesn't stimulate a passion, it maybe develops their visual literacy, you know, at least an understanding of how they should or how they can see the world. The community involvement in the Black Swan is, I think, a very strong defining feature of the prize. It's one that positions it in the cultural field very uniquely. I think it helps to bring a much broader, a younger, and a much more lay audience to the arts.